You just explained it. You articulated it so well, Mr. Casho. It's like what I don't understand is PAGCOR gives a license for a POGO hub. To put up a POGO hub, you need to spend billions of pesos, right? You're talking about how many buildings was in Porac? Is that like 40?
46, ma'am.
Oh, 46 buildings in Porac. So you need billions to put that up. So you grant a PAGCOR license, the investor, malakas ang loob, they'll say, may lisensya tayo. So let's spend billions in Porac. Let's put up the POGO. And then suddenly you cancel the license, you leave them alone. So my question is, what does PAGCOR say? Where does their responsibility lie? The minute they cancel a license, they let it be?
Well, we've been revisiting this issue time and again since May of 2023, when the commission started raiding rogue POGO, so to speak, no? And they've always stated in our various meetings in Malacañang or whatever public fora that we are in, we are together, they say that their mandate only allows them to visit a particular hub only in so much as it has a license. If they lose the license, it becomes a law enforcement issue. Now, then again,
But
they really have
does
to answer.
PAGCOR,
Yes, ma'am.
did PAGCOR at least report? If they say it's a law enforcement issue, did PAGCOR at least coordinate with the LGU and the PAOC or the PNP to say, oh, wala nang lisensya yan ha, dapat yan, pagbukas yan, isara nyo, arestuhin nyo lahat. May ganun ba ang PAGCOR?
In all honesty and fairness to them, they have submitted a list of 58 canceled POGOs that, to their knowledge, are still operating. No, unfortunately, Karen, I've stated in previous interviews that operations of this magnitude spends around 35 million pesos. No, so if you've got 58 times 35 million pesos, you can do the math. You could only imagine the drain it takes on the resources of the Philippine government. But it does not mean that we're not doing anything about it. Kaya lang talagang sagad-sagad. If you don't mind me saying, we're only 47 in our particular office. And we are merely a coordinating agency. We have to ask the assistance of the PNP, NBI, DOJ, Immigration, and the like. And they've got their own priorities as well. So when we raid a particular POGO, we look at it in terms of priorities. And what do we mean by priorities? If someone's life is at stake, like in this Porac hub, meron ho kasing dalawang torture videos na nakarating sa amin. And a sex trafficking video was also sent to us. So we had to act on it immediately, no? We don't take our sweet time. But we had to make sure that we stand on solid legal ground.
But I think at the end of the day is, let's be honest, when PAOC, actually it's the PAOC that's doing more than its job when you think of it, right? When you raided Zunyuan Technologies in Bamban, at the end of the day, a POGO hub with a license ends up doing activities and they use the license to cover the illegal activities. You found what? It was being used for love scams, shopping scams, human trafficking, same thing in Bamban. Now in Porac, it's used for prostitution, different scams, etc. So at the end of the day, whether or not you give a POGO hub li a license, when they say, it's legal, it's illegal. At the end of the day, they both do illegal things.
Sad to say, you are correct in that assessment. A good number of these quote-unquote legal POGOs are hiding behind the veneer of legality to be able to do illegal activities with impunity. No, it is for that reason that we keep on asking the PAGCOR, as the primary regulator of POGOs, that their presence is not sufficient to check what these particular POGOs are doing. And remember, Karen, we're only talking of the legal POGOs. We know for a fact that there are 402 canceled POGOs as of last year, and a good number of them, between 100 to 300, are still operating. We only have a list of 58, but it doesn't mean that the rest of those canceled have actually stopped operating. So this is a very, humongous problem. This needs a whole of nation approach. We need the involvement of the community, of all government instrumentalities down to the level of the barangay. Kasi po, hindi namin kakayanin ito. Hindi kaya ng PNP, hindi kaya ng PAOK. Whew, this is a very big problem.
Yeah. So let's be honest, Mr. Cashono. So there are roughly 45 to 48 licensed POGOs in the country. 43 licensed POGOs in the country. But the estimate is more than 300 illegal POGOs, correct?
Yes, ma'am. Okay. I don't call them POGOs anymore. I call them scam farms. That's what they are.
Okay. All right. But at the end of the day, if it's a POGO hub, kasi that you have buildings that you have to build, right? It would mean that they had a license, because no investor would spend on building infrastructure unless may lisensya yon. So that's number one. My question is, at the end of the day, is it really the mayors at fault? They know the POGO in their town. I do not believe that a mayor does not know if there is a POGO on his or her town. Imposible.
I agree, Karen. Kaya nga po, ang aming panawagan sa DILG, they need to call the attention of all the local chief executives where these scam farms are located. Be they legal or hiding behind legality or what. Kasi hindi ho talaga may kukubli. They are all sticking us like sore thumbs. You've seen Baofu in Bamban. It's like, it's called the BGC of the North, the BGC of Tarlac. You've seen how large, how huge the one in Porac is. So basically, no self-respecting local chief executive can tell himself or herself that I didn't know that they were doing this and that. You cannot give me the argument that I canceled their permit. I didn't renew their permit for 2024. But then again, they've operated up until June 4. It's a more than 10 hectare building, a 10 hectare complex. Imposibleng hindi sila mapansin, right? Mm-mm.
Yeah. Well, it's either two things. Either these mayors are incompetent or they're benefiting from POGO themselves.
At the very least, it's incompetence, Karen. I hate to think of the other side of the equation, but this marks of incompetence at the very least.
Okay, Mr. Casho, about the POGO hub in Porac, give us an idea. So there are 43 buildings, 46 structures there. Are we talking about, is this a 10-hectare property? Because Bamban is 7.5 hectares. Island Cove is 13 hectares ang Island Cove. How big is Porac?
At the very least, ang Porac ay 10 hectares. Pero we're still waiting for the tax declarations with regards to this particular property. Kasi we've been getting reports that since this is part of the Grand Palazzo complex, this could go as high as 30 hectares daw po, no? We'll check. We have yet to get copies of the tax declaration in relation to Lucky South 99 and Xisheng, the other POGO that is the other canceled POGO that is subject of our search warrant. So it's huge.
Okay.
It's really huge.
It's huge, massive. I want to ask you, how many Chinese nationals were working in Lucky South 99?
Karen, hindi bababa ng 1,000 ang nagtatrabaho doon. Kaya nga when we
Chinese
when
nationals?
We first arrived,
Mixed.
Chinese, Malaysians, Vietnamese, mixed po ito, halo-halo. So less, less than 1,000. What? Come again, ma'am?
Nasaan na po sila, sir, itong mga foreigner?
Yun ang nakakalungkot na bahagi ng aming trabaho. hindi may tatatwa that our operation was compromised. And this was not the first time that the PAOK's operation against this particular Togo Hub scam farms have been compromised, no? So it's quite obvious that someone, somewhere in the long chain of government or long chain of applying for the search warrant or whatever, someone within our ranks, among us, leaked this particular information. Kaya nga po kami ay masusi nag-iimbestiga, and we've called on the different member agencies who participated in this operation to subject all its members to an investigation, beginning with myself, because together with the legal officer, we were the ones who developed this particular case operation. No? So we arrived there June 4. The entire building was dark. The complex was dark. The complex was closed. No one was inside the facility anymore. People were outside the facility. So all that you could do is simply exercise what is known as a welfare check in search for the possible victims that they were trying to rescue. So that's the bottom line. So where they are, I could hazard a guess by saying that they've simply relocated to other scam farms scattered all over Central Luzon and in Metro Manila.
All right. So we don't have enough time now, but I do hope to have you back on Head Start next week, because this is an ongoing investigation. And I know that you're not yet finished, right, in checking Porak. I think you have 10 buildings to go. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Uh-oh. So sana po, sir, on Monday, I can have you again so we can have a thorough discussion about this. But anything you'd like to add today? Because we have another guest this morning, but this is very important, really, just for us to really push through with this discussion. What are your plans today?
What are my plans today? Basically, to be able to go to Porak and make sure that everything is above board and we're able to meet our timeline to conclude our search no later than Sunday. By Sunday, we mean to say we'd have to apply for an extension of our warrant probably by tomorrow, because we only have 10 days. Now, second is I'd like to call our agency, our commission, our chairman, the executive secretary, and our executive director, Undersecretary Gilbert Cruz. We would like to call on all local chief executives. Please help us in the fight against scam farms. Please, motu proprio, don't wait for the national government to go and raid and disrupt these scam farms. Motu proprio, act on your own. They're scattered all over Central Luzon. I hate to name the municipalities because I don't want to put the local chief executives in a very bad light, but please, they're all over Central Luzon, they're all over Metro Manila, they're all over Calabarzon, they're even in Cebu province, they're even in Palawan. They're scattered all over. Simply act on your own, motu proprio, and help the national government rid us of this problem. Thank you, Karen.
Thank you. On that note, thank you so much, Mr. Winston Casho, for joining me today. Thank you.